welcome to my excellent video. Today we're talking about why eggs turn solid when you cook them. Normally you would expect things like ice or water or most other solid things to turn to liquid and then gas when they're heated. Even metals do that. But look what happens when you turn, you can see what happens when you turn ice to water. It just heats, becomes liquid, and then becomes gas. When you do the same thing with an egg, which starts off liquid, you can see it moves all around, it doesn't do that at all. When you put an egg on a hot pan, it starts to turn solid. And in this video, we're going to talk about why that happens.
Eggs, especially the egg whites, are rich in proteins. And these proteins cause the egg to become hard when they're boiled. A protein is a chain of amino acid strings that fold back on themselves and are held in place by weak bonds. When you break those strings by various methods, you're denaturing the protein. There are four main proteins in egg whites. The first one we're going to talk about is ovalbumin, which represents almost 60% of the whole egg, and it's almost a spherical glycophosphate. Ovotransferrin is 13% of the egg, and made up of two phenylonic hydroxyl groups and a nitrogen atom. Strong binding with the iron inhibits the growth of microorganisms, including salmonella, in the yolk. When you heat an egg, protein gains energy and shakes apart from its bonds. The amino acid strings cause the proteins to unfold, and as the temperature increases, the proteins gain enough energy to form a new covalent bond with the protein molecules, and these bonds are much stronger. Ovomucin is a relatively small protein whose amino acid chain is a wide variety of carbohydrates. Because of its polar character, ovomucin forms fibroid-type structures. The high viscosity of the egg white layers is a consequence of the high ovomucin content. Lysozyme, as implied by its name, is an enzyme, and it's found in other animal tissues too. It cleaves specific bonds in polysaccharides that constitute the cell wall of many bacteria. Lysozyme thus has antibacterial properties and provides the embryo with a measure of protection against infection and in its developmental phases. I hope these are really cool things to know, and thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it and have an excellent day.